SoulCollage is a process based on every soul's innate love of images, its inspired childlike imagination, and its powerful intuition. We call these the three magical eyes: images, imagination, and intuition. It's a process of making individual cards for all the different parts of yourself and of people you love and of archetypes that come in to speak to you and draw you, and even the animals in your chakras. I love my cards, and I'm sure you would love your cards too, because they are creative, fun to make, and anyone can make them, and they're also powerfully transformative.
SoulCollage is a personal visual journal that you create to access your inner intuition, your inner wisdom, and also your resources. SoulCollage is one of the many wonderful tools to address the question, who am I and what am I doing on this earth?
I want to tell you how easy it is to do SoulCollage. Anyone can do it. My grandchildren love to do it. Older people love to do it. You can introduce it to your friends. You can use it if you are a therapist with your clients. All you need are some scissors, some glue, some backing for your cards, all the same size. We use 5x8 particularly because it's a manageable size, and you can get these on our website or you can make your own. And a frame is often useful, and I'll show you why in a second. But the main thing you'll need are magazines that you can get from your doctor or from the library. Just lots and lots of old magazines with good images in them. And then cut and tear images to your heart's content. Don't go looking for specific things. It's important that you don't become very intentional about it, very left brain. You don't go looking for an image for your critic or your perfectionist or your happy child. You just begin to leaf through a magazine, and just with that unconscious part of you ready to reach out and grab an image. And, oh, wow, I love that image. I don't know why I love it, but I love it. I've got to have that image, so I'm going to tear it out. And you tear it out and put it in your pile. And then you keep looking. And you keep looking. And you keep looking. And I have a lot of cards that are that way. And, for example, this card, this image of this child, is so delightful, and it was just grabbed me when I saw it, and I had to pull it out and make a card. And then I put images of my heart chakra animal, my lioness, around her. But I love this card, and I had no intention when I started out looking through images that I would find this happy child.
So the process of making the cards, it's actually quite easy. You don't have to be an artist to enjoy this process, and it's also very enjoyable. Finding images in the society, in the world we live in, is very easy. We have a great abundance. There's plenty of magazines all over, and then you can just Let yourself go through them and just pick the ones that in that moment call to you. You find images because that image speaks to something inside of you that you might not really know how to define, but you sense it. So it's very important when you have an image that calls to you to start looking at bringing it out from where it was and putting it into a different context, and then see what other images want to go with it. And eventually you come to a place where you have organized your composition and you put them on a card. And that's your first soul collage card.
I think there are very few communities, spiritual communities anyway, that have focused on the uniqueness and fostering the uniqueness as well as the one. They usually focus on the one, either the one guru or the one universal, but not really bringing out the individual potential that gives to the one. I think what SoulCollage has that a lot of communities may not yet, and maybe, as Seena says, a lot of communities that we don't even know of are happening out there with hope. And we have values of creativity, values that everyone is unique and has a gift to give. We have a value of abundance and mutual encouragement and acceptance of others, and a value of our intuition, of what we know that we don't know we know, and inclusiveness. All of this without dogma, but with some wonderful ritual. Seena came up with, I think it was the second training, she said, I got it, we do this card circle. So we have something that we have all participated in, even people that will see this video or hear this audio years from now, maybe, will have participated in the card circle ritual of the training, where everyone steps into the center of SoulCollage in their life and looks around and sees how they're connected to everyone else. They go in there stepping on other people's cards, as we all do in community. We step on each other, but we get there.
So there are different suits in SoulCollage. Seena Frost, the author of the book and the founder of SoulCollage, has defined four main suits. The first one is the committee, which is the psychological suit, a part of our inner self, as well as the roles that we play in life. The second suit is the community suit. That has to do with our connection with the larger group of people. In this suit, we put friends, family, we put mentors, teachers, whether we have met them personally or not, whether they are dead or alive, it doesn't matter. And these are somehow our support system. Then one more suit is the companions. And that is the suit that brings in the energetic experience of being in our own body. And it is inspired by the yoga tradition of the chakras, and to find an animal for each chakra. And the reason is that animals carry an instinctual energy, and they also become very powerful symbol of wisdom. The fourth suit is the council, and the council is the realm of the spirit, the realm of the archetype. Another card that is very important to make is what is called the source card. And the source card doesn't have a shadow and is not ever consulted, because the source is really about honoring the experience of oneness. And for each of us, there might be different words that we choose to describe that experience. It could have a religious connotation, it could have a spiritual connotation, or it could have just a connotation of the experience, that the desire that we have to connect with something that is larger than us. You know, we all have the experience of being many. We all play different roles in life, from the natural one of being a daughter, for example, in my case, becoming a mother, you know, being a young woman, being an old woman, being a person who tends to the house, and a person that has a professional image. So there are many, many of us, not just one. But in the same time, we all have inside that desire for oneness, that desire for connectedness, interconnectedness also with our natural reality. And SoulCollage is really a unique tool in the sense that it honors both. Sometimes, especially in moments of stress, we forget how many resources we actually have within. And doing a reading with SoulCollage usually really brings up exactly the pieces of you that you might have forgotten you have. Because I think remembering is at the key of spiritual development and personal development. We tend to forget who we are, we tend to forget where we're going, we tend to forget to keep the mind focused on the things that really count for us. And I find the SoulCollage has been very helpful for me to remember.
When you have gathered up some images, then sit down and start to cut. And you may want this frame to see what you can get. For example, sometimes there might be a very large image like this, and a frame will show you that you don't always have to use the whole thing. You might even just use half of this face, just maybe the eyes and the mouth. So the frame will show you that. But say I'm going to make this card, and this is my, I would say, my inner explorer self. So I'll cut it out, and actually, you know, it's almost perfect the way it is, but I will look for another background. After I get it cut out, I'll perhaps put it on a background that shows even more the exploring nature of this child image. So then I'll glue it down. I will put it on my card and with the new background, and pronto I have a card, a new card. Now you will find that you have inner wisdom that come from these cards. When they speak to you, they come from a place that no one can tell you. A therapist can't tell you what this wisdom is. A book can't tell you, a sermon can't tell you, a lecture can't tell you. Only your own inner wisdom can tell you what these images will tell you. So try it. Get busy and try it. Just find some images and see what grabs you and start cutting.